Hi guys, this is Jonah Said of Cairo. From home, from a very, very hot day at home. Very beautiful, but hot day, as you can see. And this note, inspired by dancers from all over the world, is specially dedicated to my students of my new Joana Saíra's online dance school. This note is inspired by you and is dedicated to you, all of you who have already joined me for our group online classes at the school. You rock, guys, and thank you so much for all the support. I can only assure you that the school is going to get better and better and better because of you, okay? Having said this, let's go to the note. And this one is about perfectionism, the plague of perfectionism, something that I observe in amateur and professional dancers in everywhere I go, every country I teach, every country I perform, every competition I judge, you know, everyone, and I mean everyone without an exception, at least in the last 10 years of my career, everyone that I've seen is suffering from this plague, from this obsession of achieving an ideal of perfectionism that actually doesn't exist. You know, perfectionism is something that we build within ourselves. So I have my own idea of what a perfect dance is, and everybody else has their own idea, and nobody is right. You know, who can say who is right, what is perfect? You know, criteria changes constantly depending on your knowledge, experience, maturity, intelligence, many things, okay? But independently of the criteria and you having the information to build an idea, a clear idea of what is a quality piece of dance, perfectionism is something that we keep ahead of ourselves to keep us from achieving constant and permanent and present joy. And the thing is, aside from being an illusion, a construction every single person builds inside of their head, perfectionism stops you from enjoying now, enjoying the moment now, which means if you don't consider you are at your best, you are perfect, that you have achieved that ideal that you have in your head, that means that you're suffering, you know, you suffer. You don't allow yourself to enjoy, to have pleasure in the dance, to have pleasure in exercising, to have pleasure in taking a class, even facing challenges, you know. And this is something that every artist in every area knows. You are never, never free of challenges. You are never in a state where you feel you know everything. You're totally confident. You're done. You've achieved maximum maturity. I don't believe in this. You know, if you have any creative vein, any creative blood boiling inside of you, I'm absolutely sure that you will die thinking that you haven't done it yet, you know, that you can grow, that you can learn, that you don't know much. And the more you know, the more you're aware of how much you don't know. This is a classic, you know, but it's true, at least according to my experience. So my note here is for you to drop perfectionism, okay? I don't mean that you should strive for excellence. That's something different. Every day I try to be better than I was yesterday, but I don't let my demands, I don't let my ambition smash, destroy, annihilate the joy of the moment. Even if I know I'm not at my best, even if I know that I can do better, I can always do better, I don't allow that willingness to improve, okay, to erase the potential joy in every single moment of dance. So even if I only know 5% of the subject, I enjoy those 5% and I do it with full presence and full love and full passion, yes? If I know 10% and I know I'm unprepared, but you know, I'll get better, I will not allow those 10% or the lack of the 90% to erase the possibility of a great time while I'm dancing. The same applies to everything else, you know. I love cooking, for instance. I'm not a great cook. I don't have time to cook. That means I don't have the practice. I know that in order to be a great cook, I would have to dedicate my time and my focus to it, which is deposited in other areas, okay? Nonetheless, when I cook, even if it is not the perfect cooking, you know, it's not perfect dish, but I enjoy myself. You know, it is not a 5 Michelin stars kind of plate, but it's done with love and with joy, and it's the best that I can manage right now, and I'm perfectly okay with that. If one day I'll become a great chef, who knows? Well, let that day come when it comes, if it comes. Until then, I will enjoy myself. I will enjoy the journey. I will enjoy the doing, the process of doing. The same applies to dance. So quit perfectionism. Be totally present. Enjoy. Dedicate yourself. Yeah? Put goals ahead of you, but don't let them eliminate the joy, the pleasure, the celebration possibility in every single moment of dance, okay? Because that joy, that celebration is at the core of Egyptian dance. So by killing your joy, you're killing the dance spirit, yes? Give it a try.